Oh, there we go. The microphone is muted. Hello, everyone. This is HTS Yuski here, and my mouse is freaking out. My goodness, this is like the roughest start I've ever played, or I guess ever casted in StarCraft 2. Let's just go ahead and reset. So just clear our minds and pretend like that never happens. And a three, and a two, and a... Hello, everyone. This is HTS Yuski here, and I am back with some more StarCraft 2 action. That was a bit ridiculous. I don't know why that intro was so difficult for me to handle, but this time... I just realized this is another PvP. Okay, I want to talk about something really quickly. And actually, this is a little bit of a rant, and I've thought about it a lot. Looks like they're laughing. I know that that's Korean for, like, laughing. I don't know what all the other stuff is saying, though. I will introduce our players. In the top left side, it is EG's JYP, and in the top right side, it is Liquid Hero. So something I want to rant about really quickly. No, not that PvP is boring, because the last two PvPs with Liquid Hero have been awesome, and I actually wanted to watch more. Did not know that this was yet another PvP. We'll see if Liquid Hero can redeem the PvP matchup single-handedly and make it interesting. So the thing I want to mention really quickly, maybe it's not a rant. I wouldn't call it a rant, but one thing that's been bugging me, so maybe it is a rant. Anyways, one thing that's been bugging me is a lot of the pro teams out there, and no, I haven't been making a list of like which pro teams are doing this and which ones aren't and all that. But the one team I've obviously kept an eye on because I've worked very closely with them for a long time is Team Liquid. Now, most of you know Team Liquid. They have the website, Team Liquid, and all of that. And one thing that Team Liquid really has been doing lately and as well as in the past that really I think is perfect is that they are supporting their members and marketing them as a not only a team but as personalities. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, if you join Team Liquid, you're getting a couple of things that I think other teams are not providing. Of course, you're going to be getting a salary. You're going to be getting training partners. You're going to be getting your travel covered to the major events, things like that. That's the basics of running a pro gaming team. Apparently, we have some probe on probe action down here. Oh, does get the surround, but manages to escape. So Team Liquid does the same thing that everyone else does, but something else they're doing that other teams are not doing, and I think it's a huge hindrance in esports, is they're not marketing, or they are marketing their players as personalities. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, they're releasing replay packs. They're writing huge news articles about their players. They're covering their players, whether they do good or bad. They have a website dedicated to their team, and of course, they allow their team members to post on their own forums with their own, we do have Double Gas Studio, by the way. We do have, you know, they're able to post on the forums. They get a custom icon, everything like that. And the thing that really bugs me about a lot of other teams out there is that they are not marketing their players. And I feel like in business, in any business you're in, marketing is extremely huge. Marketing is what makes UFC make so much money. Marketing is what makes every company make a lot of money. Marketing is so important, no matter what business you're in. And something that esports teams are not doing is marketing. A lot of the teams out there do not release replay packs. They do not have people talking on their behalf on forums. They do not have major coverage at all these events. The only players from teams, from a lot of teams that are well known, are the ones who are marketing themselves and have no help whatsoever from their team. For example, In Control has done pretty well at some tournaments, but overall, the last season at MLG, he didn't do well. He has a ton of fans. Why is that? Because he's marketing himself, putting himself in podcasts, doing things that are useful, doing things that are funny. He's a very likable guy, and he markets himself. But a lot of the players out there, I don't want to use any names, but a lot of players who are really good don't know how to market themselves. Idra knows how to market himself. Huck knows how to market himself. White Raw knows how to market himself, but a lot of the players out there are not getting enough love. So if you are involved in an esports team, start releasing the replay packs. Start putting a name out there for your players. Start giving them, you know, kind of this persona, this image, and start building up their fans. Don't just pay them a salary and expect them to perform well. Build them up as part of the community instead of someone who just has to do really well. So that's something that's been bugging me, where Team Liquid, they're constantly sending me replays. They're constantly uploading replays to their website. They're constantly promoting their members. And all the other teams out there, for the most part, I think EG kind of does this, but a lot of other teams out there do not promote their own members. And I feel like that's kind of a sham. Now, we do have the two stalkers gonna get trapped here by Liquid Hero. He's known for being very aggressive in the every stage of the game, including the early stages in PvP, does end up with a pretty severe loss there. 475 resources to 300. Both have lost four units, though. If we do take a look at the units tab here, There is a probe advantage for Liquid Hero, so he should have a little bit of an income advantage. Yes, he does. You can see how just one or two probes does make a major difference here. And so he's continuing to Chrono Boost out those probes. And yeah, both players just making probes one at a time consistently as they both have expanded here. So there's not going to be any amount of cut workers. They're most likely going to continue producing probes from here on out, especially since they want to get this expansion saturated as quickly as possible. Nice probe transfer over there. Looks like he's going to transfer about 12 down there. And where'd that other probe go? Oh, that's the Immortal. He is running around with an Immortal right now. What is this Immortal doing? This is like the Immortal that thinks he's a Zergling, just kind of, you know, herp derping around trying to find some pylons to kill off. But thankfully in PvP, you're not going to usually find, you know, five stalkers randomly intercepting this to snipe it out like you might see with 6 to 8 Zerglings, or any amount of Zerglings, really, because they're always all over the map. Now, it does look like JYP. I do want to mention, speaking of Team EG, he is on Team EG, so EG versus Liquid, always a good grudge match to have, as they are both really kind of two of the best teams outside Korea, and they also have players that play inside Korea, so a big fan following there for both of these teams. And the Twilight Council does have Blink on the way. The Observer's like, oh god, get me out of here. And he will indeed survive. But the JYP is going to know, hey, there's an Observer scouting my base. Nothing I do is really all that hidden. And what is the income looking like here? Virtually identical, but you can see Harvesters 38 to 43. Liquid Hero has been Chrono Boosting very heavily. When I play StarCraft 2, of course, I'm only Diamond League. So it's definitely, don't take it as being more important than what these players are doing. But I prefer to Chrono Boost out workers as much as possible as Protoss. You can get your economy going insanely quickly if you keep dumping those Chronos into the economy instead of Chrono Boosting out the actual units. And that's what Liquid Hero has been doing, and that's why he has 5 more workers, while his opponent is relying more on Chrono Boosting out things like Blink. You can see the Blink is nearly completed compared to Liquid Hero's, whose is not quite done yet. He is Chrono Boosting out this Immortal here. He does have... it does look like he ended up losing that Observer to... Yeah, he did right there. Looks like Liquid Hero warped in a stalker on the low ground to chase down the Observer using his own Observers there. So yeah, using the Chrono Boost on Economy is how I prefer to play. But we're going to see how this plays out between these two players with them doing it slightly different. Where is going more for Economy and one's going more for the units. Now we do have 3 Gateways on the way for Liquid Hero. No Colossus Tech on the way. Is instead relying more on the Immortals. There goes the Robo right now for both players. And again, it does look like one of the Observers does get taken out. Is going to be working on destroying these rocks right here. And this is really interesting. I think this is a smart choice by him. Because if for some reason JYP has his army down here, say defending a potential third base, and Liquid Hero is blink stalkering back and forth, he can actually sandwich these units and trap them and do a substantial amount of damage. Now, it does look like Liquid Hero continuing to scout out the main, knows how many gateways there are, knows that Blink is going to be done, and we do have a pylon snipe right here. This is good on by JYP, not able to kill it off, though, as Liquid Hero was able to defend. Neither player going for an attack upgrade or anything like that. Does snipe the Observer, and now we have a very awkward Blink Stalker battle here, as this Observer is basically on top of this army, knows exactly what's up, and good control by JYP, but is it going to be enough? It looks like this army is completely trapped, and yes, it will be enough, completely surrounding this army, and what a devastating loss there for Liquid Hero. That's what I was talking about, is getting the flank on that army is insane. A good read there by JYP. And look at the units lost, more than double for Liquid Hero. So that is bad news for Liquid Hero. He does have Forge going down right now and is working on the extended Thermal Lance. Both players opting to not go for the Warp Prism play that we've seen players do. I believe it was in the previous PvPs we watched Liquid Hero do. But Liquid Hero really kind of getting baited into that trap, and that worked beautifully. That's the kind of stuff you're having to do now in PvP, is not just get a big death ball, because players are going to punish you for it. And right there, multi-pronged attacks, always awesome in PvP. We're starting to see that a little bit more and more. Now what we are seeing Liquid Hero do here is try to be aggressive with 3 Immortals. He will have an Immortal advantage, but I don't think that's enough to take on this entire army. He is forced to turn around the Immortals right there and does trap a lot of the stalkers of his own. So the Immortals are all in range. This guy right here just now out of range. But if he can kill off this Colossus, that would be huge. I think he is going to have to retreat here. This may have evened the score a little bit. Can he get the Colossus? No. He does decide to blink forward, though, sacrificing all the stalkers to kill off the Colossus. And the units lost here is still favoring JYP. But if anything, Liquid Hero was able to kill off that very important Colossus. And what else do we have going on here? There's 2 Observers down there, a probe down here with a pylon, so nothing really happening on that side of the map quite yet. JYP is warping in a bunch of stalkers down here. He's going to try and intercept these units as best he can, although JYP overextending himself just a little bit. with a couple of stalkers, but he does manage to regroup them. I thought he was going to blink down and try and get some sort of Zerg surround going on. But he did not be able to do that, and we do see the observers now just continuing to scout out the base, see if there's anything hidden, like a double robotics. That's something that Liquid Hero is going to have to know about immediately, should that begin happening. Both players do have the plus one on the way, but right now Thermal Lance is done for JYP, but no Colossus in sight. The only one is at halfway through the center of the map, so he's going to have to wait for that Colossus to get over here, and he does get it. If he attacks right now, well, he might have the plus one attack upgrade advantage, although I think he should wait here for just a second. He is going to try and go for it. You never want to go up this ramp, though, if you can help it. He feels like he has a bigger advantage than he really does. This was a slight mistake by JYP. He does have his stalker spread out now, and that is when it starts to favor JYP, is because he can start taking out all these additional zealots. And if you look at the supply, if he can kill these zealots, he's going to have a huge advantage just because the supplies are even. But JYP's army, I mean, if you look at it right now, he has a lot more gas in his army composition. That includes your sentries for the Guardian Shield. That includes your Colossus, everything else, and a lot less zealots as well. Now, he does have the plus one attack advantage, so now would be the time to try and put on the hurt. He does go directly into the main. The Colossus does stay behind. He wants to kill off these stalkers if he can, but pylons are good as well, especially if he can supply block his opponent. Because you got to remember, in PvP, those pylons are going to have to be rebuilt almost no matter what. That pylon that survived before now barely falls to the last shot there, and no zealot charge for Liquid Hero. So these zealots not really going to be doing all that much. The zealot charge does help out quite a bit. This observer has spotted one of the observers. We do see Liquid Hero going to be putting down some more proxy pylons there. The third base is on the way for JYP. Looks like JYP is going to take out the observer. Goodbye, observer. And does he know, is there still the second observer? No. Looks like he ended up losing both of those. So good sniping action going on there. And so now the observer advantage is going to go to JYP, which does delay the Colossus production. Anytime you kill off the observer, you basically delay a Colossus by the duration it takes to remake that observer. And in PvP, a lot of times it does turn into War of the Worlds, where whoever has the most Colossus is going to have a pretty significant advantage. That poor little probe is going to get taken out by that stalker. The plus one, now plus two on the way for both players. And the plus one is still ahead for JYP as he continuing to chrono boost it. Not at this very second, but something. Oh, there he goes right there. Realizing he needs to get that out. Also, a second robotics, a great choice. But Liquid Hero may be doing some multi-prong attacks with his warp prism that he has on the way. We've seen a micro colossus in and out of a warp prism. Don't know if we're going to see that, but most likely we are going to see some warp prism harass. Maybe it's going to be with two immortals, or it could be two immortals in the major battle, dropping them next to the Colossus, also absorbing some of the splash damage. So there's a lot of things you can do with the warp prism if you have the APM for it. So now we kind of have to keep an eye on where that warp prism exactly is. There it is right there. What is going to be inside of it? Right now, nothing. He could potentially just warp in a bunch of units and attack. Is he going to do a multi-prong attack? Once again, he does have the zealots in position to do so. There is two cans here to defend it, and still no zealot charge. Looking like he's going to go straight for the robo. May kill it before this Colossus spawns. He will indeed. And it looks like the army is now split up to try and deal with this, but this ball down here is way more than he needs to kill off those zealots. And Liquid Hero does it again with the multi-prong attacks, but a lot of damage being dealt to these stalkers. Can the blue ones chase him down? Yes, they can, but warps in a lot of zealots here, so these stalkers may have to retreat, and now the zealot charge is done. So that means that these blink stalkers will be forced to blink inside the main. The Colossus trying to do some damage, does rake in two kills, and the plus three attack now on the way for JYP. Liquid Hero has not even begun his plus three, so if we can see continued chrono boost on that plus three, he is going to have a huge upgrade advantage. We do have a couple zealots down here trying to recreate the success, but you got to be Liquid Hero to do that. You cannot snipe this Nexus with three zealots, as this army is in position to deal with that quite handily. Now we do have a Dark Shrine on the way for JYP. Can he make it work is the real question. Is he going to use the DTs, or is he going to transform them into Archons? Of course, you can make two DTs, two High Templar, or a mix of one and one into an Archon. A lot of people do forget that, but you can indeed do that. And right now, I'm not quite sure. I mean, if we just look at the units lost, I mean, it's fairly even. JYP is still in the lead, but Liquid Hero has been able to claw his way back into this with 54 harvesters to 57. The income is virtually identical, plus his gas income is higher than his opponent, even though he's mining only on two bases here with that gas. I'm not quite sure what is going on with that. Oh, he never remade them inside the main base. Only three probes mining out of a total of what should be six. And there is 600 gas remaining on that geyser, so it's definitely worth looking into mining that. But right now, the supplies are virtually identical. If you do look at the units tab here, a much heavier Zealot composition, but he has mixed in a couple Archons now. And quite frankly, the unit composition for Liquid Hero favoring that of JYP's, because, I mean, if you just look at this, same amount of Colossus, so that's tied up. But Zealot Archon, I would say, is much better than just a couple additional Stalkers. Even that one Sentry is not going to do all that much, because the Colossus can just stomp on the force fields, and the Sentry has such little HP that Colossus most likely would just kill with splash damage during the Guardian Shield anyway. So JYP, though, is going to have that plus 3 attack advantage, and that can play a ridiculous role with the Colossus splash damage, and we'll see if he's going to be able to utilize that. It just now finished. He wants to move up here, do as much damage as he can. Does take out two Stalkers immediately, even setting a tree on fire in dramatic fashion. A lot of people forget that you can set stuff on fire with your Colossus. And a lot of the other flame units as well. Now we do see the Zealots going to be rushing up here once again. Liquid Heroes doing it again with the counterattacks. And look how quickly they'll kill this cannon. Goodbye, cannon. Plus two attack is very good at killing probes as well. These probes need to evacuate out of there. And he does manage to get quite a few kills. Liquid Hero with the attacks at the expansion. Oh no, putting them on the geyser. That's not a good idea, as that just makes it much easier for the Zealots to kill them, as they are not running away. Generally, you'll see the probes run towards the army, but he did lose substantial amount of mining time there. 42 probes now to 55, plus it's even less because about 8 of them aren't even mining right here, so he does need to get those back to work. They're still just sitting there, and that is going to hurt his income, but he does have the upgrade advantage. What is the army looking like? 10 to 10 on the Colossus count. Everything else is just kind of pretty close to the same, but we are going to be seeing two more Archons here, I believe. Yes, they are on the way. And so we will see if the unit composition favors Liquid Hero right here. I would say that it was, but this attack needs to happen before that plus three it kicks in. He needs to do some damage right here. Liquid Hero does have the concave set up. His opponent's trying to gear up for his own concave. And this is the awkward moment, man, when both players know that a battle is imminent, but Liquid Hero is going to finish his plus 3 attack upgrade. He also wants to fight next to this cannon, which kind of sounds silly, but when these armies are so identically matched, you want every advantage you can get, and static defenses basically count as a unit that doesn't take supply if you are engaging directly on those units, or directly on the buildings there. So it does look like the DT not able to do all that much, as the Stalkers were able to clean that one up, but both these players just kind of sitting back, and we get to have the Fleet Beacon on the way now for Liquid Hero. May see him even sacrifice a couple of units just to get out of Mothership. Wouldn't be surprised if he would do something like that. And both players are trying to figure out exactly how they're going to go about this. We have a second Fleet Bacon. So I guess that JYP smelled the bacon cooking over at camp. Liquid Hero got a little bit hungry, decided to cook his own bacon. There goes a couple probe kills, just because, well, honestly, he wants to free up supply here, especially now that his Fleet Bacon is done. Does he decide to make a Mothership? That is really the question we've all been waiting for. There it is right there. And indeed he does. The Mothership is on the way. Does look like the probes finally got back on the gas right there. So we'll be mining. I'm kind of curious on the income here. It is virtually identical for gas. It's the minerals where JIP is really shooting ahead. Now during this you can begin adding on a lot of gateways as well, as additional forges is kind of what you want to be doing right here. You can see he is adding on two more gateways. And really the bases are so big you can add, you know, 6 to 8 more gateways up here. And then getting the forges, double forges at a time going is very crucial. Is going to go ahead and upgrade these guys to Archons. And even, I don't think we will see Psystorm, but Psystorm would be pretty interesting just because there's such a big army for Liquid Hero. But he's so good at splitting them up that Psystorm, as if it wasn't worthless enough versus Protoss, Liquid Hero's not going to bunch up. Just a bunch of Stalkers going to come down here to try and save the Nexus. The Nexus will fall, but you got to remember, Liquid Hero does not have a Nexus of his own up and running right now. Basically for a fourth base. I think it's just now finishing. Yeah, it's just sitting right there. No one's mining from it yet, though. So he basically had to do that just to be on even footing as far as the economy is concerned. Because you can see, I mean, our JYP has more resources in the bank. And he, I believe, has an upgrade advantage. Does have the plus 2 armor on the way. But currently tied on the upgrades. But he is ahead on getting out that second armor upgrade. And the Mothership nearly completed. I feel like this is kind of like the countdown to New Year's, waiting for the Mothership to appear here. That'd be a pretty good way to celebrate New Year's, I would say. Have a Mothership. That'd be a lot more exciting than a little glowing ball, I'm going to be honest. Now, the Mothership has indeed arrived. Of course, it does cloak everything around it. For those of you who don't know, it even cloaks buildings, which is pretty fancy schmancy, and we'll see if he decides to do that. Look at this. JYP tells these probes to commit suicide, and they can't even do that correctly. They're like hanging out right here. It looks like they're ready to go. They finally do their job correctly. The program for those probes had a little bit of bad programming there. Because you gotta remember, probes, I believe, are just machines, right? There's no like probe essence or anything like that. So whoever wrote that script for the suicide command evidently loves probes because he didn't want them to die. Now he is warping in a couple more zealots down here. Literally a couple. There is two zealots who are forever together. And they will indeed die together one by one. And he's going to see the upgrade advantage if he doesn't know about it already. Look at that. Begins immediately upgrading the plus two armor. And I am surprised not to see someone get an additional forge and start working on the shield upgrades, because those shield upgrades are important. But both players just kind of chilling out, trying to poke in and out, which sounds pretty sexual, but just using one or two units at a time and trying to see if there's any weakness in the opponent's army. Decides to drop down a couple cannons here for defense, as he has seen a lot of the zealot counterattacks more inside the main base. Literally, he's just forcing his opponent to retreat back and forth with groups of units. And I think more power to him. He's just investing resources in this, not including investment gas, just the minerals. So if he can take out these pylons, it's just really frustrating. There he goes right there, going to be focusing them down. And since this base isn't really laid out all that well, killing off a couple of pylons is easy. It will begin unpowering these buildings. And then you just have to bring a probe up here and start rebuilding those, which is annoying. Does look like the warp prism will get taken out. Goodbye, warp prism, but not before the zealots are able to do quite a bit of damage here, so we will have to rebuild this. And yeah, Liquid Hero, I was going to say, he backed up his entire army. JYP did, so now he can get the center map position here, and the concave is non-existent. Why you would bring this many units back to defend is exactly what Liquid Hero tricks Protoss into doing quite often. And quite interesting here. Now he's got the sick concave in the center, and we don't have a mothership, I believe, for JYP just yet. Oh, yes, we do. Where's your mothership, JYP? You got one somewhere. There it is. Just now spawning and moving out from that bottom expansion. So now both players have a mothership, and how is this going to come into play for these players? The mothership just barely out of range. It's not cloaking anything. It is going to keep it back just a little bit. And the plus three armor nearly done for JYP, so he still is ahead in the upgrades. Honestly, I'm just going to speed this up a little bit. I feel like neither player is doing all that much. Just going to be adding on gateways, robotics, everything like that. But this army is massive. Three attack, three armor. This is why getting those shield upgrades would have been absolutely handy. You have a zealot counterattack down here. Not really counterattack, but just sending out a couple. Apparently, we have five probes on this gas. That is the best Vespene gas in all the land. Does look like the four, our fifth base will get taken out here. Neither player going to be able to establish one. Does force the cancel. Getting a near full refund on that one for in-store credit on your next purchase of a Nexus. And we do see, what is the Colossus count to? It is 12 to 10, 11 Archons to 8. So who has, what's going on here? I guess a lot of it's just the Zealot supply making a bit of a difference, plus a couple Stalkers mixed in. So slightly better unit composition still for Liquid Hero. Even putting cannons in the center of the map, that's going to make it virtually impossible to break on an even footing. So it's just going to come down to unit positioning and things like that. No Psystorm, but here we go. Is he going to go for it? No, he doesn't. The mothership, though, does reveal herself. So both players know, if they didn't already, that indeed there is motherships about. Yo mama ship indeed. Now you got to remember that JYP does have the upgrade advantage, but it's got to be short-lived. Is now working on the plus shields, which is something I think he should have got a little while ago, as it is now 33 minutes into a game. Talk about a bonkers PvP, as Liquid Hero is trying to just do as much damage as he can with a couple units here and there. And so maybe now would be a good time for JYP to attack, but he does decide to take out, or try to take out, this watchtower, and does do a little bit of damage to that Colossus. We'll see if that plays a major role here. He's trying to force Liquid Hero out of position, and maybe moving through here would be just too dangerous because of the splash damage. And no Psystorm. I don't think I've ever seen Psystorm in PvP, at least within the last year on the professional level of play. You just almost never see it. We talked about that a little bit in one of the previous games. But the plus one shield's about halfway completed. Plus three armor nearly completed for Liquid Hero as well. So I guess we speed up the game here because we're waiting for both players. It does look like they're both talking. He's trying to figure out, I'm guessing, what to do. And honestly, the best idea is just to add on a bunch of gateways, attack, and immediately reinforce it as those units are dying. And I think that's the most important way to take this game right here. But there goes the mothership. He may do a mass recall. Is he going to do it? This would be huge and absolutely ridiculous. I don't think I've ever seen something like this happen before, at least not on that level. No, he does go for it. Just Zealots does get the feedback. He actually brought that War Prism over to try and feedback on the mothership, which would cause only shield damage, but also prevent it from mass recalling. So this is a lot of Zealots inside the main. Which building is he going to go for? Looks like the robotics facility first. Could potentially delay the upgrade for the Warp Prism as well if he can kill that off. I don't know if he's going to be able to kill it, though. And no, he is going to be able to defend. And it does look like the Warp Prism just being so frustrating. But he decides, you know what, killing it's probably a good idea. And no more High Templar to chase down that mothership to prevent it from getting any recalls or anything like that. So what a silly, silly game indeed. And he may even leave this High Templar up here to try and intercept the mothership, but he doesn't. Where did the mothership end up? There it is right there. Slowly going to begin regenerating that energy. Can't believe I've seen feedback used in a PvP. Almost feel like we're going to see High Templar feedbacking High Templar, which is just so ridiculous to even think about. But is he going to be able to feedback on his own mothership? Right now would be a good time for JYP to go. He needs to do the splash damage, but no, he has allowed Liquid Hero to get through. Cannot believe he missed that opportunity. So he's gonna have to back out and do his best he can. A lot of cannons are on the way now. And who's got the better concave? It looks like he's gonna be able to take out a couple of Archons here. So this will favor JYP. And he will force the recreation of those Archons. Not quite sure what they're saying here. They're probably laughing about it. Just because this game is so silly, they're not quite sure where to go or how to engage. Looks like mass cannons is going to be the answer here. 37 minutes into a PvP. This is why you don't, I guess, ever see it this often, is that these players don't know quite what to do, because there's never, they don't usually find themselves in a position like this. Now we do have DTs going to be moving in and try and start harassing here. We've seen Liquid Hero be able to do a lot of damage with this in the past. Can he recreate that success right now? Still surprised to not see more gateways from our blue Protoss. He does have quite a few Robos right now, I believe four. So he can, you know, do a lot of cost protection. And we do have Psystorm. Looks like Liquid Hero may actually go for either Mass Void Ray or Mass Carrier. He does have the Graviton Catapult, so something's saying Mass Carrier. And that can be good, especially at these situations. Even Mass Void Ray can be pretty good, because with so many of the Colossus, there's just not enough anti-air to kill it off. Now he's going to be doing some basically two-pronged attacks here, attacking the main base and the expansion by moving this Warp Prism around. He's also going to be killing the gas income for JYP. So doing a little bit here and there, but in the main base, another mass recall. Has the Immortals in here, has the Archons and the Colossus. Can Liquid Hero get in position to defend this, or is he going to lose his main base? I think he needs to not focus down the robotics here. Instead, he's using Colossus on these units. He does back up into a good position. Does he have a shield upgrade advantage? No, the upgrades are identical for both players. The shield upgrade just now going to finish, but I think it may have been a second or two too late to really benefit him in that battle. He is able to kill off a couple of the Archons, though, and does get that last one right there. The units lost here is still favoring JYP even this late in the game, showing you how hard it is to get ahead when you get that far behind in the early game, because it kind of just snowballs out of control. Now, it does look like he's going to go for these cannons. He wants to kill them off while Liquid Hero is out of position, but it's just so many cannons that they're actually doing substantial damage. The Colossus do outrage them. That's something you do have to keep in mind. Here's the Void Rays for JYP. He did decide to switch it up. Void Rays are so good in PvP. Already has the two attack and the one armor. We have 2-2, though, done for Liquid Hero. So both players really trying to spice it up here with some mass air, and not really sure where to go about, you know, attacking at this point, because with so many cannons there, what can you really do? I mean, you can rely on your Colossus, but then only your Colossus are attacking, and you can't beat an army that has everything attacking with just pure Colossus at this stage. So 3-2-3 is the name of the game for the ground army, although only one shield upgrade here for JYP. I thought he was going to get it sooner, but maybe I got him switched up. I thought he had the plus two done, but I guess not. And here comes a major, major battle. I don't think I've ever quite seen a PvP battle like this. Liquid Hero's positioning was actually not that great. A lot of his Colossus on the side were not attacking. And you can see that JYP basically pounced on that. And now we have this awkward stalemate where both players do have their vortexes thrown down. One random DT going to be harassing up here. And it does look like that battle will end for now. Although that definitely, I thought it favored JYP. But, you know, that did free up the supply for five carriers. Where are these carriers being made? This is going to be hilarious once they spawn. Five carriers right here. Croto boosting all of them to get them out as quickly as he can. could even make a sixth at the same time if he wanted to. That is just young money right there. Buying the fanciest cars. These are basically the Cadillacs of StarCraft 2. He's going to have five Cadillac SUVs popping out of here. And that may actually end the game. Because, well, I don't know. Void Ray is pretty good versus carriers if you focus them down. And we do have the Graviton Catapult on the way, which I thought was already on the way. But maybe I'm just completely mistaken on all this stuff. But I feel like that was on the way already. Maybe it did get delayed, or he decided not to go for it quite yet. I do apologize for missing it, but it does look like he's going to go ahead and attack right here. And let's go ahead and hide the UI. The five carriers are not completed yet. The Void Ray is trying to go straight for the Mothership. This is one of the most widespread battles I think I've ever seen. The Mothership does go down. Now the Void Rays are just going to go to town on these Colossus. This is what they do best. Supplies heavily favoring Liquid Hero though, but it's only because of those carriers which have not arrived to this battle yet. So that means that JYP will be able to push this army back. And did even the supplies quite a bit. Can he go for the expansion? Will he be able to get it? Fully charged Void Rays are so powerful. Where are the carriers at? He hasn't quite revealed them yet. He wants to get more interceptors to do a surprise, you know, kind of KO punch on all these Void Rays. But they are going to kill off this Nexus, which means that neither player has a fifth base right now. And if we look at the income, neither player really mining all that much. I mean, you would expect to see this in the earlier stages of the game off of maybe like two base, but definitely not when they're on four base. Might as well take out this building just to pad the unit's loss charts, which are still favoring JYP here. Looks like some harassment continuing down here. The Warp Prism may indeed get taken out as the Stalker attempting to kill it off, but nope, scoots on out of there. And I don't think JYP realizes exactly what he's getting into. He's gonna be like, I did not sign up for this. Oh no, the trap is ready for Liquid Hero. JYP not going to expect this at all. And as soon as he reveals this, it is gonna be it for this army. And you can see JYP's like, Oh, I see. So you're going to play this game, which is sit back and get a bunch of carriers. Which carriers are pretty freaking good. If used correctly and at the right times, that's what an extinct geyser looks like, if you're wondering. Not a whole lot of Vespine coming out of there. And it does look like JYP is going to go for broke here. He's sending everything he's got. This base just now thrown down. Can barely afford it. He does have a nice down payment on there. But I don't know if it's going to last. If this game's going to last long enough with how many carriers are on the field. And I love how low to the ground carriers like to fly. Even though they can fly from planet to planet, when they're fighting, they fly so ridiculously low. Does look like the DTs are going to take that out. Is that a GG? I'm not sure. But he's still going for it, still trying to take this one out. But there's the carriers right there. They are going to kill off the Nexus. Does force the cancel, which means that these probes can expand somewhere. But these probes are long distance mining in the wrong part of town. You got to watch out for these carriers. Could try to expand right here. But I guess it's just going to be a base race scenario as, well, I mean, really, what can you do? The probes pulled off the line, but Colossus, Zealot, pretty good versus probes. Really, anything is good versus probes. And it does look like the Nexus goes down, so the only remaining mining base has been taken out. And look at how far they have to long-distance mine. Absolutely bonkers. He did decide to make some Archons, which is why he is completely broke. The carriers are coming back. It's a carrier race over here, five carriers at a time. And it does look like he tried to blink forward with the Blink Stalkers. Not that you can blink with anything else. And tried to snipe the Mothership. The carriers will be able to kill this Mothership quite easily, I feel like. And the Vortex goes down. But Liquid Hero whiffs it. Not going to be sucked into that trap. And he's going to try and kill off these so that there can be no more carriers. But the supply is still relatively even for both players. If we do look at the army size, 95 to 73 though, so it's definitely favoring Liquid Hero here because these probes are not doing anything useful other than long distance mining. Here, what could potentially be the last battle, is JYP going to commit here? Look at this Mothership trying to kill interceptors. Not something you see very often. The Mothership has fallen, and I believe the rest of the army is going to go down as well, blinking forward to try and take out the carriers. Or is it over? It looks like the Void Rays will be able to do some damage on the carriers as well. But there's the GG from JYP. Right before his last unit really ends up dying. Yeah, he had a Stalker and a Colossus, which was basically on the deathbed. How much HP did that thing have left? 4 HP, and managing to win with carriers. So as usual, it's my personal goal to have Blizzard keep the carrier in the expansion. We'll see if that actually happens, but I feel like carriers are just so much fun to watch. And if you haven't watched them in StarCraft 1, definitely go check out the old carrier plays because the interceptors had much different AI, which means the carriers were microed much more heavily. So it's pretty interesting stuff. So that is that. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.